Coming up today, we sat down with the Yearbook crew.
We ask what students plan on doing this Halloween season.
And NTV's Andrew Motes breaks down all the sports info. All this and more coming up on NTV. Good morning, McKinney North High School. I'm Julie Elise Hernandez.
And I'm Daniel Lopez.
Every year, students of McKinney North High School look forward to the yearbook. We sat down with Ms. Carmichael and the editor to see what it takes to make this happen.
Ms. Carmichael and yearbook editor Abby Collins explain what goes into making the yearbook every year.
Well, we start in early September, late August, just as soon as school starts, and we go through March, and we go to all the events, we interview a lot of students, we try to include as many people as possible, and we just put it together slowly.
There's a lot of different things that we take. We take pictures, we take quotes, we take stories from all kinds of people, we take our own experiences and try to help other people come up with their experiences. There's a lot of deadlines, and we have to like nail that into people's brains that there are deadlines.
They then go on to explain what their least favorite thing about making the yearbook is.
Getting students to turn in everything by deadline, getting people to take their pictures, making sure everybody's correctly identified.
Probably just keeping everybody on track. I try to like be as nice as possible because I don't want to be like one of those mean people. I'm not a mean person. And so when it comes to like trying to make them listen and like get it done when they need to get it done, it's quite challenging.
Next, they say how long it takes to finish the yearbook.
We start as soon as school starts, and we go through March. We have to wrap by March in order to get it back by the end of school in May.
It takes all the way up till spring break. We start, and it just never ends. It's just a constant, like taking pictures of random stuff, taking pictures of things that need to be taken.
We then asked how the students contribute to the yearbook making process.
Oh, they do all of it. I edit, I check and make sure things are grammatically correct and spelled correctly and all that, but they take all the pictures, write all the stories, figure out what the theme is, they do all of it.
Each student has a specific page that they chose or were assigned for each year, or for each sport or subject or event, and so that's their page and that's the page they have to get done.
They then spoke to us about why it is important to buy a yearbook.
When you're my age, you're going to want to look back at your high school experience because you're going to realize how fun it really was. And just for those memories, I know that sounds cliche, but it's true.
It's important to buy a yearbook to me because I love the memories and looking back on them and just a reminder of like how like high school was and that, because like being a senior, this is your last year, but you also have the book that reminds you of everything. And plus, like for me, it's helpful because since I'm new, I can look through one and like know who people are.
Lastly, Ms. Carmichael explains why the yearbook is so expensive.
It takes us so much money to make it. We don't make a huge profit on the yearbook. We're just trying to pay the cost of actually creating it. The yearbook is $65 right now, so buy it when it's still cheap. And then senior ads need to be purchased and turned in by November 11th.
This has been Mitchell Martin for NTV.
If you have any questions, speak to Ms. Carmichael in room E106. This week was Halloween, so I went into the halls to ask students what their plans were for the season.
Are y'all ready for Halloween this year?
Yes. Yeah, I'm so excited.
What are y'all plans for tonight?
She's coming to my house and we're watching movies.
Yeah, we're gonna probably pass out candy.
Are y'all watching any horror movies?
Yeah.
No, she's too scared.
No, I'm not. We're watching horror movies.
Anyways.
What's y'all's favorite type of candy?
Hershey's.
Sour Patch Kids.
Could you do us a favor and look into the camera and do your best scared face? You ready for Halloween this year?
Yes.
What are you gonna do tonight?
I'm gonna go trick-or-treating with my little sister.
What's your favorite type of candy?
Kit Kat.
Kit Kats?
Yes.
Okay, can you do me a favor? Look into the camera and do your best scared face.
Oh my god, okay.
Are you ready for Halloween this year?
Sure.
Yes.
What are y'all doing for tonight?
I'm gonna go trick-or-treating with my family.
I'm staying home.
What is y'all's favorite type of candy?
Probably anything chocolate.
Same.
What is your worst fear?
Worst about what?
Worst fear.
Probably that guy from the movie, you know that movie Napoleon Dynamite? Remember that? Yeah, the bully. Yeah, it was the worst.
Thanks, Daniel. And now to Andrew Motes with an update on sports.
The McKinney North football team played against Newman Smith on the 26th. They beat the Trojans 67-30. The cross country team will be competing in Round Rock, Texas this Saturday. London Colbert, Richie Dulab, Brendan Corcoran will be running that morning. Finally in golf, the Boys Orange team finished second place in the district preview tournament held at Frisco Lakes last Monday. Grant Lanier finished second place individually with a score of 73. The Blue team won their district preview tournament with Pierce Jones and Dawson Lafferty finishing third and fifth place respectively. That's all for sports. Now back to you.
That's all we have for today. For more news and sports information, follow us on Twitter at MNHSNTV.
Thanks for watching.
Have a great day, Bulldogs.